fourth quarter set to go here at McDonough. McDonough in their black uniforms, number one ranked Gonzaga trailing 12-6. In their white uniforms, Booker Corgan, Ty Zanders bringing the call. Fourth quarter brought to you by LaxWorld and LaxWorld.com. LaxWorld, a tremendous organization. For decades, they've been bringing you the best in lacrosse gear and apparel. Chaos to start the fourth quarter here. And McDonough comes away with it. Ball knocked down. And that's going to be over and back. Great play by the McDonough attackman right there. Number 19, Jack Park, who simply just dropped the ball. He very easily could have tried to roll that somewhere and get a little slick and get a flag. But he just dropped it. That's the way you're supposed to do it. Luke McKayla behind the cage, patient, but they cannot afford to be too patient. Oh, high pass, and this will be over and back against Gonzaga. See if he drops it. He does. Some smart guys, great coaching.
Tough turnover there for Gonzaga. Sure, they would have loved to get a goal there and just chip away at the Eagles.
Jay Juranic, number one, gets it down to the McDonough offense, and they lead by six. No hurry for the Eagles right now.
I got to imagine they'll be patient with their offense, maybe see a stall call or two or three.
Another pickoff by defenseman Will Rock.
Good job of getting his stick in the passing lanes. Anticipating that.
William Fitzpatrick, number 14, pushes it up. And now it's Michael Stanton. And Ty, I got to ask, Gonzaga's had a tough time with their footing today. I don't understand. A lot of slips.
And not the Gonzaga team I've been seeing the last few games. Some against BL and then again against Hill Academy. They played yesterday, actually, in a game against Bishop Barton.
Great save by Stover on the come-around attempt that time. And now ball in on the crease feed. Picked up shot, goal, rebounded by Michael Stanton. What a great play by Stanton to stick with it. 12-7. And just like that, Nick McAvoy is back out at the faceoff dot.
Let's go, Block.
Gotta
make the play.
Gotta
make the play.
Let's go, White. One at a time. Here we go. Gotta credit McDonough's faceoff crew today. Did a really good job against McAvoy and company. I think people were definitely nervous when Orlando went down in the preseason. Banged up a little bit. We'll be back in a few weeks. But
Jordy Lardo, you referenced Jordy Lardo, the face-off star for McDonough with a lower body injury, i.e.
Whatever
hamstring.
That is, who knows? Broken toenail? Yeah. You never know.
Lower body. Something below his nipples. And you can milk anything with nipples. I have nipples. Could you milk me? Stanton, little give and go. Rich Slater. Over, inside. What a save by Stover. I don't know how he did it. Not up in here. Not you, fat Robin. Jesus. What a save. Dives across with no chance to stop
BJ it. BJ Ferrar in transition. He can run. Great football player. Tremendous wheels.
Could that be a game-changing save? Stover with no business making that save. And now a reckless turnover. That's going to be over and back by McDonough. Uh-oh, Chris. Oh, great lob across the top. And Sam Offit, he took care of the faceoff duties while McAvoy was in the box. And this is Brian Townsend. Rich Slater, Stanton behind the cage. 12-7 your score, 8-18 to go fourth quarter, brought to you by LaxWorld. Shot just wide. Ball inside, knocked to the turf. ball's off McDonough right now. Saved on the sideline, and it's going to be McDonough possession. Some tense moments here. Defensive number 34, Brendan Scher for the Eagles. Great ground ball play. Jay Jeranek running for his life, number one for the Eagles. Here's Stover. Stover with a simple job on clears. And we're going to get a moving pick call. I'm not sure about it, but look who has it, Will Rock. Third rock from the sun. Passes Monahan, shot cold. Timmy Monahan from Will Rock.
If you're going to lean on someone, lean on Timmy Monahan.
And it was Monahan who just got robbed by Stover earlier.
Making up for it there.
And now it's 12-8, 7:30 to go fourth quarter in the Royal Farms Game of the Week. Surcharge-free ATMs and amazing world-famous fried chicken. Royal Farms, real fresh, real fast, real free. Get to your local Royal Farms store. It is the place. Timeout by McDonough. Fourth quarter brought to you by Lax World. Go to laxworld.com and get all your equipment and apparel and swag. Play the game by the people who can provide you with the best in the game, Lax World. 7.5 minutes. Four-goal game. Number one ranked Gonzaga trailing 12-8 against the number eight ranked McDonough Eagles here on the Royal Farms Game of the Week. The best in high school lacrosse action. Great crown ball pickup, but an equally great defense. Nick McAvoy comes up with it, and now the Screaming Eagles have possession. The McDonough Eagles possess. And here's Robbie Black now with possession for the Eagles. And Rock comes out on him. You almost hear the Jaws theme playing as he approaches the ball.
Gotta let him run! Go D!
Connor Young. Connor Young comes away with it. A little worse for the wear.
A little lumber there. No call.
They get dodgeball. The Lumberjacks didn't lay that much lumber. Oh! Barrett Sutley. And the jig is up on the McDonough offense. He clearly could have shot that ball. And the referees picked up on that, too. Timer on with 6:17 to go in the fourth. Fourth quarter brought to you by Lax World. And it's back with Connor Young. Pick and release. Robbie Black now has it. They got about 13 seconds to shoot. Inside feed. Shot. Goal. Number 19 on the release. Jack Parr slinging it. With 5 seconds left on the shot clock. And Ty, we're going to have a tough time in distinguishing who's the Under Armour elite, underclass elite star players of the game. We might have 5 or 6 guys today.
The whole team out there.
Yeah.
Making a party.
I mean, I figure I get Stover. He's played well.
Maybe Clark.
Clark. Parr. McAvoy.
Jack is on par.
Nice, Ty. Well played.
Well, I do believe that's his Twitter handle, so don't give me any credit.
Avery Myers, cross-crease feet, handled by Stanton. Great finish. Luke McCaleb, correction. I thought that was 18, not 16. McCaleb finishes it. That'll wipe out the penalty. The penalty is wiped out. 13-9 now, your score, 5:30 left. And each faceoff becomes more and more and more important. Noah McCoy against Nick McAvoy. Let's can't say enough about the quality coaching in this matchup. Andy Hilgartner and Casey O'Neill. I'd love to see these teams play as best of seven series. And McAvoy puts it right back to Ridge Slater. But as is the letter of the day, there's pressure over everybody who picks up a ground ball in the middle of the field. Somebody get Luke McCaleb gets it back over Michael Stanton, now all the way up top to Avery Myers. A little give and go attempt, but Myers clearly guarded. McCaleb comes up with a ground ball, and now it's Timmy Monahan. And you can see him try to set those hands.
You know he wants the ball on his stick. Under 5 minutes to go, down four.
Offit trying to back his man down a little bit, flips it over to Monahan. Timmy Monahan comes out righty, lobs it up top to Ridge Slater. Slater gets past this man, comes out righty, shot, goal. Ridge Slater taking the bull by the horns. That's how he handles his business.
Not just a metaphor. Ground balls and wing play.
It's a metaphor,
indeed,
but that really happened.
In Slater's game.
Ridge Slater, a little shake and bake. Abracadabra on the inside. The Magic Man and El Diablo. I mean, what can't you reference right now, Ty? 13-10 with 4:32 to go. Fourth quarter brought to you by your friends at Lax World, the only option. If you're looking for lacrosse equipment or apparel, go to Lax World, laxworld.com. Liam Fitzpatrick with a great catch there. Oh, what a pickoff! Every face-off, the guy who comes up with it's been contested hotly. Fitzpatrick with another shot at it, he comes up with it. And for that, he gets double-teamed by two poles. He's going to draw a push. He actually could have drawn a slash there, so that's fine. This is unbelievable. They're going to back Timmy Monahan up, and he's going to give it over Luke McCaleb, number 16. 13-10, Gonzaga making a run. Here's Monahan. Timmy Monahan rolls out, comes out righty. Ducks his shoulder, shot early. Don't know if we had a backup. They do. And Luke McCaleb with it. Keep your eye on number 18, Michael Stanton on the crease. He comes off on the wing and gets it. Stanton ducks his shoulder, cross crease pass. Tried to force it there. A little too much one-on-one right now for Gonzaga. Let's run a play. Stanton. Mono a mono. Timmy Monahan comes over. Turns him back. Stover, quick pass. And now it's Monahan. Barrett Sutley in the middle of the field with a step. Sutley, little time. Skywave is at the top of the box.
Sorry to cut you off, Booker.
Sorry. Here's Robbie Black. And now McDonald looking to run some clock. Robert Clark shares it. Three-goal lead with 3:10 to play.
Stay with him,
Hank. McDonough clearly looking to purely run out the clock. 2:50 left now, fourth quarter. Roll dodge by Clark. Ball goes on the ground. Rock looking to kick it up forward. And he gets... Gonzaga comes away with it. They throw it all the way back to Christopher. Bit of a mess at the top of the box. And now it's in the stick of Ryan Finley. Finley crosses midfield. We might get a timeout early here. And Gonzaga is on sides, and there's Jack Myers that are on sides. I counted three guys. Now they have four guys back. They actually have to correct them. They were on sides. It's a tough call. It's a tough shake. I actually looked back and counted and even said, when Finley went over, I said they're on sides. And they subbed a guy through the box, and that's what threw the ref off. An unfortunate turn of events right there for Casey O'Neill and the Gonzaga coaching staff. Pass by Stover, right on the money again. Love his clearing game tonight.
Stover has been huge, both making stops in the clearing game. burn the clock here. Don't want to give Gonzaga the ball, but running out.
And this is Jackson Morrill now behind the cage. Double teamed by Gonzaga. He puts it on the turf. Rock comes up with it momentarily. Makes a nice play on the ball on the ground, but McDonough comes up with the ground ball. Tough situation. Luke Vassos didn't know whether to take the man or the ball. And Connor Young all the way up top. And here's Barrett Sutley with 1:22 to go. Fourth quarter brought to you by your friends at Lax World and LaxWorld.com. The only place to get great lacrosse equipment, great deals on apparel. Go to LaxWorld.com. Shot saved by Christopher with 1:05 to go. He's forced out the back, gets it up. And here's Luke Vassos. Running the field, sharing it with Jack Myers. Myers right-handed sweep across the top. Back to Offit. Offit shot just wide. And the McDonough defenseman clearly had the backup there. Timeout by Coach Casey O'Neill with 47 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, brought to you by Lax World. Fourth quarter, 47 seconds left. Rich Slater, quick dodge for Gonzaga. Double team comes. Slater somehow keeps it to stick. And here's Avery Myers, inside feed, shot over the cage. Luke McCaleb, number 16, with the shot. Here's Timmy Monahan, 31 seconds. Monahan's going to take a running start, come around, right-handed shot. Stover fights it off. Luke McCaleb, up top, Rich Slater, hold shoot. Just wide, 21 seconds left. And Monahan. Quick dodge by Monahan. Ball flies, flag flies. And with 15 seconds left, Gonzaga will go on the man up. But McDonough's going to take down the number one team in the country right here.
Crucial big win for McDonough.
The number eight ranked McDonough Eagles, their only loss in overtime tilt against the Haverford from Philadelphia.
In my opinion, there's no way Gonzaga is going undefeated with how tough their schedule
yes.
is. But McDonough is a really, really strong team and the real deal here. Probably the team to beat in the NIAA.
Pass knocked down. Great play that time by Brandon Scher to knock it down. Now ball loose. Finished by Timmy Monahan, but too little too late. That'll make it 13-11.
All right.
Huge thank you, first and foremost, to my main man, Ty Sanders.
Always
and
a pleasure,
Bush. Dual Cam Productions, our title sponsor, Royal Farms, and then the Baltimore Crabs, FCA Lacrosse, Riley's Oyster, and Lax World. Get your stuff at Lax World. For everybody, I'm Booker Corian saying thanks so much. We'll see you next week with the Royal Farms Game of the Week.